whilst it didn't start at Nvidia, it has been Nvidia tech for a very long time now. Nvidia's PhysX is not a name you hear that often anymore, but I do remember it being discussed very often back in the early 2010s. Games like Borderlands 2, Fallout 4, Planetside 2, Witcher 3, Killing Floor 2, all had some level of integration with PhysX. Now, as the name would suggest, and as Whisper likes to do every time I try to say PhysX, it tries to correct me on it, this is Nvidia's physics simulation tech. Nowadays, it's no longer just on Nvidia hardware, and it's not really marketed in any sort of publicly facing way. Now, honestly, the most you would have heard about PhysX recently, besides what we're talking about today, is with the release of the 50 series of Nvidia cards, they drop support for 32-bit PhysX. So for games of that era, like Borderlands 2, if you had PhysX enabled, it would run faster on a 10-year-old system than it would on a top-end one from today. And recently, this story has been floating around. Nvidia PhysX and Flow are now fully open source. Flow, as you might be able to guess from the name, is Nvidia's fluid simulation library. In many cases, these would be used hand in hand. This change was put in place alongside this release, Flow 2.2.0 and PhysX SDK 5.6.0. Big emphasis on the fully open source, because you may have heard stories in the past about specifically PhysX, not Flow, PhysX going open source before. Nvidia has this trend of saying they're gonna make something open source and then doing so in very small parts, very slowly over the years. Great example of this is Nvidia's Linux drivers. So the kernel modules, those are open source now, but the user space driver part, that's still proprietary. Nowadays, the proprietary driver does make use of those open source kernel modules, but there's still this like half open source weird thing going on. Maybe at some point the entire thing's gonna happen, and that's where we are with PhysX now. Back in GDC 2015, it was announced that PhysX would go source available on GitHub. This was available on their website. PhysX source on GitHub, and you'd like sign up for it. It wasn't just publicly available. You'd be in their like weird developer program sort of thing. Yeah, this was like a weird first step, but hey, it's better than nothing. Now, one thing I don't understand on this page is Windows, Linux, and OS X. I don't know what this is. I've never heard of this operating system before. Anyway, you'd sign up shortly down the line, they'd send you a link, and there you go. Now you can see the code, but it wasn't open source. It was only source available. This continued for about 3 years until this repo was made in 2018 with the project mostly going open source. So most of it was licensed under a 3-clause BSD license. However, there were still certain proprietary blobs that existed that obviously were not open source. And the license is a standard license, nothing really too special here. Redistributions of source code must retain the above copyright notice, this list of conditions, and the following disclaimer. Redistributions in binary form must reproduce the above copyright notice, this list of conditions, and the following disclaimer in the documentation and or other materials provided with the distribution. Neither the name of Nvidia Corporation nor the names of its contributors may be used to endorse or promote products derived from the software without specific prior written permission. And then the provided as is notice, like you see in something like a MIT license. Very standard license, very normal open source license. Now I mentioned blobs. That would be the GPU simulation kernel, because Nvidia. I don't know why they do things the way they do things. I'm sure somebody in corporate could tell you if they actually cared to. Now, all of that changed about 7 years later, bringing us to where we are today. Now, there is a quote in this article here, but it is not the entire quote. I don't know why they decided to do it like that, but the quote comes from the GitHub discussion. PhysX and Flow GPU source code now available. Since the release of PhysX SDK 4.0 in December of 2018, Nvidia PhysX has been available as open source under the BSD 3 license, with one key exception. The GPU simulation kernel source code was not included. That changes today. We're excited to share the latest update of PhysX SDK now includes all the GPU source code fully licensed under BSD 3, with over 500 CUDA kernels powering features such as rigid body dynamics, fluid simulation, and deformable objects. GPU PhysX represents one of the most advanced real-time simulation use cases of CUDA and GPU programming. We hope this release will be a valuable resource for learning, experimentation, and development across the community. In addition, we're also open sourcing the full GPU compute shader implementation of Flow SDK, our real-time sparse grid-based fluid simulation library. We can't wait to see what you build with it. Explore, experiment, and feel free to post issues or feedback right here on GitHub. Now, making things more open source is just a good thing. I don't have any criticism to make of that happening. Now, I have heard some discussion around what this means and what you can do, and there's comments like that just on the thread itself. I'm talking about the 50 series and then cards newer than that, whenever the 60, 70, 80, whenever they reset the numbers, fixing 32-bit PhysX on these cards. The idea is, okay, these games use 32-bit PhysX. It's not supported natively on these GPUs. And currently the workaround to deal with this is not really a workaround. It's buy another GPU. So what people are doing is buying an older GPU. Maybe they still have an older GPU laying around from when they upgraded. And then just using that as a dedicated PhysX card. And then having their main GPU do everything else. Which, you know, is basically any GPU is kind of overkill. Like any GPU in the past 8-10 years, you could just use as a PhysX card, and it's completely overkill for just doing 32-bit PhysX in these older games. Like PhysX ran fine back then with Nvidia cards, so realistically anything you're going to be good with for a dedicated card. But it is kind of funny to see things kind of come full circle, where there was a time that you would have a dedicated 3D accelerator card or a dedicated PhysX card back when PhysX was separate from Nvidia. And now, for these older PhysX titles, people are doing the exact same thing again. Now, to be fair, most of the time PhysX's use was kind of gimmicky and frankly didn't really matter. Yeah, it's cool. Oh, you open the toilet in Borderlands, fluid flies out everywhere. That's cool, but like, you can play the game perfectly fine without it. I did multiple times, same with the other games that use PhysX. It's neat, and it's annoying that it's gone when you have a newer GPU and it runs slower than the older GPU, but it kind of is what it is. So the idea is, with this going open source, basically modders could make some sort of software-based translation tool, like you have with a DXVK, like you have with, I don't know, Box64, things like that, but a tool for running PhysX on a modern GPU based on, you know, this being open source, or just, you know, doing it through the CPU and having it be fine. I'm not an expert in GPU programming, but there is a prominent game modder who thinks this wouldn't be possible. Maybe it would be possible, but this being open source hasn't really made anything easier here. So this article is trash, complete misinformation and misunderstanding. Most of the article is literally just what was on the GitHub, so most of it's fine, but specifically this part down here about fixing the problem. PhysX 5 has nothing to do with PhysX 2 and PhysX 3 GPU acceleration. This has nothing to do with old games at all. This is just for new games being developed. Literally, this paragraph is the opposite of the truth. Now, even if that is the case, and I haven't heard anyone else make this argument before, but to be fair, most people don't have much of a knowledge of PhysX. I'm in that same boat. This is why I'm not gonna, you know, go one way or the other with this. Even if that is the case, I still like the idea of more things being made open source. More open source is more good in most situations. And this is one of those situations where I think it's just more good for more code. And that's cool. But what do you think? Let me know your thoughts down below. If you know more about PhysX than I do, I would very much like to hear that. Documentation on what modern PhysX and old PhysX, if there's some relation here. There's no documentation here. There's literally nothing here that I could find. So if you have any insight yourself, I would very much like to hear that. So if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, the Liberapay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me and gaming.